Chapter 57. The right place was the path above the river Styx. Kate jogged along the dark, narrow ledge as if it were as wide and bright as a well-lit street. I walked along behind, clutching the rusty railing, wondering if my claustrophobia had been replaced by vertigo. When I finally caught up to her, she was wearing the flashing Bluetooth coupe had mentioned. "Another pod rule," she said. "Shadows are not allowed to turn their radios off. Ever. I suspect that Laud and the originals have special transmitters in the radios and use them to track us. I've had my radio off for more than 24 hours. I'm about ready to turn it on."
"Why?"
"Because I want him to know exactly where I am. I want to continue the argument I started with him 3 days ago."
"You confronted him about murdering your parents?"
"Are you kidding? If he knew I knew about that, he'd probably murder me. I'm talking about the argument I started when he caught us. He accused me of trying to get Coop out of the deep. He accused me of trying to run away with him."
"Weren't you?"
"Of course. But if I admitted that, I'd be locked up like Coop. I insisted that I was bringing Coop in, not taking him above. I acted outraged that Laud could even think for a minute that I would leave the deep, especially with someone from above. I didn't talk to him for 2 days. Then I turned my radio off and disappeared."
"Poof," I said.
Kate smiled and took a very small radio out of her pocket. "I'm going to turn this on and put it on speaker. You might want to record the conversation for Coop. It will make an interesting addition for Coop's project if we get out of here alive." She turned the radio on.